halftime with the visiting Chiefs on top. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
It's been a tight game to this point. What do they need to do, Charles, to break through in the second half and take the lead?
Well, I think the first thing they need to do is thank their defense for keeping them in this game. And, you know, I think the defense is saying back to them, why don't you guys focus on getting some first downs, put some drives together, give us a little bit of a break here. If we can get some rest, we'll play even better for you. And, oh, by the way, pay off a few of those drives with some points, too.
Throwing again on second and 10. Hurts. Well, that's complete to Sanders. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Now on third down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. They'll set up a throw. And that will be incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
It hurts not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
I remember in pregame when we were talking to him on the field, and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to.
But first down, Hurts throwing the out route incomplete. It's Smith. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. To throw again. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. They'll come up now on second and a yard. Stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Rager catches it left side. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. This will be play number 7 on the drive. Third and a yard. Get it to the 33, good enough for a first down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6.
Chief,
Hurts. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 19. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Boston Scott scampering home from 19 yards out. And once again, the Eagles are back out in front. Will stay out there as he'll go for two. The toss running left. It's Howard, and he'll get into the end zone. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive, and they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. It's Hill, complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And Mahomes picking up the first as he slides and hits the deck. Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 15. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for him. Trying to find a place to throw the football, it's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who have had the receivers on lockdown.
Going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it, and let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. On second and 7, Hurts. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Absolutely no disguise on that one. They just went for it. Put him out there and said, go deep. Let's try and hit him. Unfortunately, to no avail.
The Eagles on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7.
You got tight right there. 18 Cardinal. 18 Cardinal.
is Hurts to throw. And the Chiefs are going to get him. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there. He was still looking through his progressions and going through his receiver options, and while he was doing that, the defense got to him quickly in the pocket.
And it was a great example of zone coverage, well executed, well coordinated. All the receivers were covered, and he couldn't evade the rush back in the pocket.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. We call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. And it looks like this will be the last play before the two-minute warning. Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he stopped at the Eagles 34. They get 9 yards back on the run there, and they're left. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. It's Kelce on the ground. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 44 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. And now all of a sudden, the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit, because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
Right back to Edwards-Helaire on first down. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chiefs are once again going to retake the lead. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. He's got it. And this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Into the hands of Sanders. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard. They'll look to throw. This is complete to Watkins on the slant. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 42. He's back to throw. I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Ooh, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
To throw. That swung out wide to Sanders. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 31-yard line. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. To throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. This secondary as a unit, they've worked really well together in this one, especially late.
A lot of cohesiveness, a lot of communication, and some great athleticism. They're playing so well now, a nickname is sure to follow. They're gonna have to name this whole unit soon.
This one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 20 yards on both of those plays back to back there. They are moving now. It's another first down. Second and 10. Sets up to throw. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. And now here comes their final timeout as they take it with eight ticks remaining. Play number nine on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Throwing is Hurts. And he's got it. It's caught for a touchdown. And they have taken the lead here in the final seconds. So with next to nothing left on the clock, they get Charles what should be the game-winning touchdown catch.
That felt so much like practice and preparation coming together. So many times your last practice of the week, you score the game-winning touchdown. Everyone leaves the field feeling good about themselves. They got it done for real in this situation.
Elliott Good with a PAT. And it would appear, barring some late heroics, they're going to get out of here with a come-from-behind victory. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They have time here, partner, for just one final heave.
And I have to look at from the defense's perspective here. We know what they're going to do on offense. The Hail Mary, try and get guys down there and throw it in the end zone, tip it around and catch it.